The whole world has just seen yet again the malice and cruelty of Putin's war of choice, rooted in aggression and waged with deep contempt for the rules of war. Every region on earth. So we gather again today to support Ukraine's inalienable rights to defend itself. And our resolve and steadiness of purpose has only been strengthened. Yeah. Now everyone here understands how this war began. As President Biden noted, quote, no one threatened Russia, and no one other than Russia sought conflict. Putin chose war. But Ukraine chose to defend itself. They conquer all of Ukraine. He assumed that he could roll into Kyiv. He assumed that Ukraine could never mount a counteroffensive to retake its sovereign territory in Kharkiv and beyond. He assumed that the world would stand, he assumed that we wouldn't summon the unity and the resolve to stand up to his gentlemen. If you want to see how mistaken those all those assumptions were, well, just look at the battlefield today. He's lashing out against civilian targets and infrastructure in Ukraine's cities. Russia's sham attempt to annex Ukrainian lands. Countries around the globe have rejected Putin's grim vision of a world where big powers can. Governments around the world have rushed to provide Ukraine's troops with the support that they need to defend their country and their citizens. That has made a demonstrable difference on the battlefield over and over again. Just as we last met in September, we've all, and despite Putin's new assaults, Ukrainian forces have changed the dynamics of this war. They've liberated hundreds of towns from Russian occupation, and they've retaken thousands of square kilometers of their land. These victories belong to the Ukrainian soldiers, but the contact groups' security assistance, training, and sustainment efforts have been vital. We've made tremendous progress by working together.